Lickers.
He's got a dead compressor. I'll show you the dead compressor. That special coil. TXV fed. Fancy control. Let's see how much gas it takes. If it'll tittle me on there. 20 ounces of 134A. There's our evap section. It's pretty standard stuff. The thing that makes it all scientific is the controls and how they're doing that and all that stuff. Solution with the probe in it so you get the actual temperature. And then I'll show you, I'll roll it out and show you the back. It had a loose wire connection and melted up a bunch of stuff.
Back of the unit. Some barbecued star components and stuff. But then the one terminal on the compressor. Yeah, it melted up pretty good. So it was time for a new compressor and condenser fan motors. So. Compressor's out, condenser fan motor's out. It's over there. I got to get the dryer out next. I got the dryer out. That's funky. Let's see. Put on the vacuum pump. New dryer, new condenser fan motor, new compressor. Came with star components. I still have to wire it up. Rocking the Smurf boner. And then my 1/4 inch by 3/8. And we got really good vacuum time today. Today it kicked butt. Sorry that it's upside down, it's just the way that it is. I guess I could spin it like that for you guys, but you know what's up. So I said I'm making my wiring, finish pulling my vacuum and then get it charged up. It's gonna be 20 ounces of 134A. The new compressor body's a lot smaller than the old ones. It really makes you wonder if it's gonna last. Of course it's not, but hey, that's what they're doing, that's what they're giving us. So the model number I changed out across to this. This is a half horse now, look how tiny it is. You can go on the Copeland app when we get it running. Maybe I'll film a screenshot and we'll see where we're at within specs. That's a great app, the Copeland app. I'll show it to you guys on the on some screenshots. I'll do the live filming. So using the field piece vacuum pump today, because I have power right here. No need for the little Navac. I just hooked up all the big stuff. Bouncing a little bit. All right, let's get this thing rolling. Okay, just got it started. We're at 20.5 Celsius.
And it's got a lot of work to do.
And a 150 head and about 32 on the suction. 8.4 amps with a hot box.
We'll watch it as it all settles down here. already dropping. Since I just filmed, suction pressure is coming down also, so is the head pressure. And let's come around here, we'll look at the temp of our box. And our temp's coming down. Remember, we're reading product temp here, not air temperature, so it's going to react a lot slower. If I put a probe in there for the air temp will be a lot colder sooner. More of what you guys are used to seeing, so. But we're reading the actual product temp on this box. So, it's a little bit different. About 15 Celsius, which is 59 degrees. That's the product temp we're reading. And then our air temp is 43.2 degrees, dropping. And so that's the difference when you're reading like air temp, product temp. I just wanted to show you guys that, just the difference. If you're sitting there wondering why it's not blowing down, that's also in Celsius, and this is in Fahrenheit. Air temp, 42. Product temp, 15.4, dropping. So that's how they do that. Saw the condenser fan not running, and so I opened this up, and this is what I found in here. Melted wire at Titus. Look at that. So we'll go for the cleanup. Little team cleanup here. Let's see. Oh yeah, look at that. I'll pull the overload off, make a new wire here. Then clean all these up. See if it lives. It lives. Fan looks like it's going slow and backwards in the camera, but it's going really fast. Definitely know your evaporator is a leaker. When you take the drain apart, the oil comes out.